Welcome back, everyone, to Phil's Recap and Review. Game of Thrones, Season 7. First look at some photos of Season 7, for me anyways, or real photos, like set photos. I was on here a little bit earlier for a longer stream. I joke about this a lot, but this really is just going to be a quick stream. We're just going to take a look at a couple of times through a slideshow. I would have been on even sooner, but I was just trying to figure out a couple of things on how to show the photos the best way. And I was having some trouble, so the only thing I can do right now is going to be like a slideshow. I'm going to put them up and they're going to go through and we'll talk about each one of them slightly and get your thoughts, really, if you haven't taken a look at them yet. Or if you have, just it'd be fun to look at them now and just get my immediate reaction, because I haven't really looked too far into them. I just looked at one because it was the front page of the article that I read, so it was the first one I saw. So I'm excited to be here. I'm excited to talk some quick Game of Thrones, a little quickie. Happy 420 day, everybody. Back one motherfucking time. Just one motherfucking time. Let me get this shit together. Yeah, fuck you. So, yeah, I didn't see this. I guess these came out last night, maybe? Link in a new chat. Sorry, I'm just opening up the live. But I'm not alone. As always, I have with me some of the best fucking people in the motherfucking world. My favorite. The awesome. The great. The amazing, as I stall for time. I said amazing. But they're that good. They're that amazing. They are the motherfucking chat. Oh, motherfucking chat. There you are. Get you back up on the screen. Okay, so let me talk about this bullshit. So far, I haven't been. We got the teaser thing a couple of weeks ago, where the walking teaser, where we got our main characters walking through, which was really exciting. I was excited for that, but what I was saying was my only disappointment in that, because I thought it was made well, that I didn't get to see any new footage, even single shots of new footage. I think I even bitched about only if they had some images, and I got off the stream, the 420 stream, and I was having some sandwiches, and I decided to, and I looked and I saw that these were posted, so I figured, what the fuck, come out here for a quick time, look at them, and I'm excited to see some actual new footage, see visually how our character's gonna look in scenes of actual moments of Game of Thrones. We're getting real now. I know we're only 3 months away, but this shit is real. This makes me want to jump and jump and jump. Because this is actual real shit. This isn't a nice song with people walking. Which was all well and good. Don't get me wrong, I like walking. I like running better, because Forrest Gump's a great movie. But I really like seeing real shit. And I'm about to take a real shit. All over this place. Yeah. Speaking of a walker, we got the walking teaser in the live motherfucking chat. Walking David. Sandwiches for all. What's up, gorgeous motherfucking walking David and all these people in the live chat? Thank you for joining me for a second time. I don't even know why I'm out here. Ultimately, I would have done this at the end of the 420 stream if I knew this was a thing. This didn't have to be its own thing. But, yeah. Guess I'm going to double fist it today. I'm not even prepared. I my water's in the other room. I still got my apple juice. I don't have any sandwiches in here. But let's get to these photos. Let's take a look at them. Okay. Oh, perfect timing. We get right on Masande. Okay. Let me size this up correctly so we can look better. So we can look at this shit better. Come on. Come on, odd size photos here. This is what I mean, that they're on sort of a slideshow, so they're just going to be kind of going back and forth. And let me put this up one, so there we go. Okay, so this is our first big one. Then we got Lady Mormont hanging out. Okay, looking like a badass. I'm going to bring her in, more Mormont. We want more Mormont. We got Davos looking all stern. I bet he's about to give that, back in my day, one of those, I'm no big city lawyer. Okay, skip. Can the photo go to the next one? But okay, we actually get to see that we actually get a moment of Sam and Gilly doing stuff while this poor girl has to pull the ever big ego of, no, I'm kidding. They have to pull Bran. Now this is a good, creepy, awesome photo. Can we have sex now? Hey, baby, can we have some sex? I want some sex. She does not look happy, and he seems to be feeding her with some whispering sweet nothings, or he's not even having to. And speaking of unhappy, can I just die already? Can I please just die already? Why am I alive? Why do I have to do this? Speaking of people that just want to die, but the Walking David does such a great impression of me. I don't want to die. Arya looking like, is this Freyland? Is she still in Freyland? She's looking inquisitively. And there is the evil queen. So we're going to go through this a couple more. Oh, and Varys. Okay, Varys, obviously in the same place as Daenerys, it looks like. This might probably be Dragonstone. And we're going to go around again. So Missandei. Okay, out of all the people, we have to throw Missandei in a photo here. Do we need to waste a photo in Missandei? No. More of Tyrion. Okay, we get Tyrion. Everyone's hanging out. They're supporting Daenerys on the way to Westeros. So the whole group, yep. Okay, the whole group getting ready. Just getting to Westeros. Hey, everybody. We're here. Jaime literally getting his blood sucked somehow in this scene. Please do, David. I can set it up if you want to. Definitely leave a voicemail. Okay, let's. I'm just going to let this scroll. Let me let this scroll through a little. I want to slow this shit down. Let me slow this shit down. Transition time between slides. Like, let's make it 20,000. Okay? There we go. It'll be a lot slower between slides now. That's better. Okay, so now we can really look at Jaime basically getting deballed. Jaime, get out of there, dude. Take that sword and stab her. How are you even there with what you just saw? Get the fuck out, man. I like you. I defend you. Leave her. Stab her. Kill her. Grow a fucking pair. But I think this is a really good photo of the two of them. But seriously, come on. Please. Save yourself. Get the fuck out of here. Now I think I made it too long in between each slide. Sorry, still getting used to the new setup here. It's better than looking at the photos like shit like they were before. Let's try this one. It's better. I'll be down. Set that. All the furs. Missandei looks awesome. Yeah, she does. Review me. Missandei is my sixth wife. Don't be hating on her. Is there a picture of someone rowing into the sunset? You like Jaime, for fuck's sake? Don't worry, I get a lot of shit for my like of Jaime. Someone's ready to jump on. They're like, who the fuck? What the fuck? You like Jaime? I like the cockiness. I think if it wasn't for somebody else, he'd had the chance to be a good man. I'm such an apologist. I can't even do it with a straight face. I'm like, yeah, I like Jaime. I'm such a good defender of him, right? But I don't claim to have rational beliefs on the people I like and the people I don't like. I'm not rational. So again, why are we wasting a slide on these two? But it is good to know that we'll actually have some time at the Citadel with them doing something, not just stopping there for a second. Sam looks like he's in heaven. But again, people that don't look like, I feel like the Spinal Tap. I look at this slide and I'm like, could it get any more white? And then I said, none more white. Dun, dun. Yeah, maybe Sam snuck her in under the cloak. This is the best photo of the bunch, right here. I mean, it's a little fan servicey here that they released this photo with the come fuck me look. Come on, I like. Come on, Brienne. And it's good to know that these two will have some more scenes in the next season. I don't mind. Be a little fan servicey with those two. They're the type to be it. And then we got Littlefinger and Lady Sansa. And I, like I said before, Littlefinger looks relatively happy, like he's talking shit about someone, probably looking down on Jon right here, talking shit about people all being on Jon's side, some shit like that. And he's whispering in her ear. Could this be... I don't know, he's somewhere. Winter seems to be everywhere at this point. Does not, like I said, not happy to be alive around nobody else we see. Or who's that? You guys can't see my pointer. What's up, Tim? Davos looks like a star. Gilly learning his letters. Zoom in. She's reading the Azor prophecy. I will zoom in next time. And, of course, we do get one of Mr. Jon Snow. Looking... Jon Snowy. Hey, buddy. Hey, Jon Snow. Oh, wrong way. And Arya. Oh, she's so cute. So murderous and cute. Like a little Chucky doll. And the Chucky doll of Westeros. Arya Stark. Good afternoon, Big E. Great to see everybody. Pick a destiny. I'm fucking ready. I can't wait. I'm just excited to talk about Game of Thrones. Even just to over... Like, not. I'm not even analyzing this stuff. I mean... It's just single photos to see kind of how our characters look in each individual thing. I mean, we can get over indulgent of like, here she is. Where is she? I already said where I think she is. This is her at Dragonstone, right? And then our next one is Varys, the same location she's in. John wants to have sex. Look at his face. He's like, I've been alive. For how long after coming back from the dead? And I need to fuck somebody. I'm no longer in the Night's Watch. And I agree. I'm not saying anything wrong with the way Missandei looks. I just, with how many episodes that we have left, I don't want any time spent on her in Grey Worm's positioning. There's time better spent in other places, but I have no problem with Missandei, Broke, or anybody else. I'll come to your wedding and offer many gifts and wish you well. Hopefully Arya. Oh, I hope so too. Arya better do something interesting. Baelish and Sansa would be the perfect couple, power couple, you could say. And here's our Dany group, as we said, arriving. Don't see any Dothraki here. I would have liked to see maybe a couple, but just for fun. Varys' clothes look like mermaid skin. Oh, yeah, David, of course. Definitely leave a voicemail. I said, you best be doing that, motherfucker. No, please do. So ultimately, and now I'll just let the photos kind of scroll by. Maybe zoom in a little bit here on a couple of them. Look at her, sitting on the Iron Throne. Look at me. Unlimited power! Oh, whoops. I don't like you, Jon Snow. I don't like the cup of your jib. Cup of your jib? Isn't it cut of your jib? I don't care! I will say what I want! I will say what I want! I'm popular! Davos. Davos. My beard in about a half a year is going to look like Davos's. By the time Game of Thrones season shows up, I'm going to look like Davos with long hair. Yep. Davos and I are looking... I'm looking more and more like Davos every year. And 2 years from now, it's going to be Santa Claus giving you this podcast, guys. I wouldn't mind me some Missandei side butthole, says Claudio. Broke. Okay, perfect gift for you guys. Now Mira is the most sad about Hodor's death right now. She's like, why'd he hold the door? Fuck me, I'm gonna pull this bastard. So it's good to see that again, but a lot of this is probably first episode stuff, I'm guessing. I already talked a lot about this photo. But Tormund's about to try to take. I don't think this is going to end good for Tormund. And okay, our power couple, as we said. They're definitely looking at Jon Snow. We're looking at people coming to support Jon Snow.
Why aren't they supporting me? I'm the Queen of the North.
No, I'm sorry. No, I'm not. I love Sansa. She's Look at all the fucks Bran's gives. Remember that time when Arya became Daredevil, says Tim? So we go around and around again. Where we stop, nobody knows. Hey, Uncle D, great to see you, buddy. Oh, and Jon Snow. Yep, someone said it before. Jon Snow was like, ah, give me. Give it to me. I'm the King of the North. I take, take, take. Almost a smile there, Jon. No, 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 no. I like it. I definitely like his look. I like the armor. This is Arya. Arya does not look like she has a neck, I agree. Get some people in the behind her. Probably still in the still at Frey. It looks like she's in the Freyland, right? That looks like the twins, right? Where am I? Danny. But guys,
I gotta burn everybody.
I think we should try to make friends and get allies.
But I wanna burn everybody.
Well, some allies would be better if they just came to us instead of
But I wanna burn everybody.
I think she wants to burn everybody. What do you think, Tyrion? Does she want to burn everyone?
Oh, my lucky charms!
No, no, this isn't the audiobook, Tyrion. This isn't the audio.
Oh, I'm Varys. Daenerys is my precious.
Oh, my goodness. Golly. I mean, no doubt. I don't mean to get to the base thing here. She is a very easy on the eyes, as they say. We're looking at the very first set photos, or apparently the set photos, unleaked, just, you know, real set photos released by HBO. Tyrion, give Tyrion some shit to do this season, like real shit to do. I hope he's just not a Daenerys toady all season, or at least within that toadiness, they have some fun with him, and he gets more to do than just going back and forth with Varys, which I don't necessarily mind, but... Give him some more dragon time. Give him some stuff to do with Jaime, maybe. Or now that he's back on Westeros, more interaction with his family again. Somehow. That's what I'm hoping for. Hello, Red Walrus. Awesome. While we listen to the remainder, while we go through the remainder of these slides, go on rinse and repeat here, because no one wants to look at me. Let's just look at the slides. We can't look at me if you want. I can go, hey, everybody, here I am, hi. But no one wants to see that shit. No one wants to see me. Get the slides back up. Oh, and they start fresh every time. Good, good, good. Thank you. Thank you, Ian. Don't forget, if you're listening and you're jumping in the live chat right now, or if you're just coming through to check out the photos and you're like, who the fuck's this at? Who the fuck is this asshole? Please hit the subscribe button so you can find out who the fuck and what kind of asshole I am. This is me right here. Hi, this is the Issues Guy for another show. I'm no big city Davos, but... Quixote, great to see you back in here. Dying to see a Stark-Lannister Sibley reunion, says Claudio. We've got analysis in there. We got our two ninjas, my loves from the Zelda stream, analysis, and Quixote. Okay, wait, freeze on this. What do we want to read this really closely? Wait, let me get bigger. Make it bigger. Make it a bit quicker. Make it bigger. Too late. It's too hard. I have to like drag. It's a weird drag tool to make it bigger. Does Uncle Pete ride dragons this season? David, I don't want to hear any excuses. So here with a amateur Davos the onion issues guy. Now for a for something completely different, we have the mediocre improv stylings. Fuck you, David. I love you. Trust me, I understand. Get the lowered expectations. No, we get the wonderful, the talented, the amazing, the better than ever. Like, but no, please go check out his Jon Snow and Rick Grimes video and all of his other impression videos where he gets to take his time and not just re-record a one-take message, because you can't even re-record your voicemails on this voicemail, so it's one and you're done. So here he is, the walking David.
Hello, Phil. I'm sure you're quite aware that winter is here. I hope you received my white raven. I sent you ours, since we won't have any more need for it.
Aware that winter is here? Oh my gosh, for whatever it's worth, Littlefinger, you're a poet and you don't even know it.
Sometime. I just had to talk to you for a quick moment before John stole the phone. John, what are you doing? What do you think?
I said, give me that phone. Listen, Phil, if you're there, winter is here.
Buddy, it's
the
here.
White walkers will soon be at your doorstep.
I agree! John!
You best be ready.
I'm ready, dude. I have you on my
Find
side.
Find yourself a Valerian sword.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Dawn. Oathkeeper. Maybe I'd even let you borrow Longclaw. Never thought it would be of any use. But just stay inside. Make sure you have enough provisions to last you 10 years.
I'm ready.
And take care of yourself.
Thank you, buddy. I got my Winter. Sword. I'm fucking ready.
Stay.
Okay. Thank you, Jon Snow. Thank you, Littlefinger. You guys have been very helpful today. Okay, I'm glad I got... Okay, I'm all set. Sorry, I gotta be careful with this sword. I can actually fucking kill myself with that thing. But sorry, guys. Thank you. Littlefinger, Jon Snow, thank you for the warnings. Thank you for calling me, and thank you for saving me from that little pinky sliding motherfucker. He's a scary bitch. But what about my lucky charms? Sorry, Tyrion. And I'm saying is the way that the fucking, if anyone's ever listened to the audiobooks, the guy, the dude that does the voice of Tyrion sounds very leprechaun-y. Hey, that's a Lord of the Rings sword. That's not Valyrian steel. Oh, I knew it. Or I think it's a Braveheart sword, actually. Oh my fucking goodness. Hey, that's from Highlander. That's from the one and only Dirty Issues Tucka. That was a gift from him. Yeah, Littlefinger, get out of here, you punk. So it feels all sorts of awkward in the right possible way to see Cersei sitting in that chair, like feeling all good about herself. It's gonna make when she eventually has a big fall that much better. And I hope it's Jaime that stabs her in the fucking head. Knife, in Joe's words, knife to the back of the head. And he just goes, listen, Cersei, thanks for the inspiration. Oh, wait, the sword, it's, fuck, oh shit. Ow, this hurts me. Freedom! Careful, Phil! But yeah, I love seeing Cersei just sit there. She's just like, yeah, motherfucker. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah. I dare you oppose me. Like we think about people when we get in, sometimes when we get in positions of power or we do things we like. You emulate, at least when you first start out, you emulate people that you respect or people that you love. Like, podcasting wise, you know, some of my favorite podcasters like Corey Coleman or something like that, the way what they did with Spill and Double Toasted or Rob Sesternito or whatever, like people that I listen to a lot. And when I started to do the podcast, I'm like, oh, I want to do, you know, like movie reviews and recaps. Like I'm influenced by dudes like that. Cersei is going to be influenced by fucking Joffrey. She's gonna be, when she starts thinking about who should I emulate as king. You know who was a good king? That Joffrey. He might have been a little son of a bitch, but I can do that better. I can be more calculating with my psychoness. So I expect her to be, in the brief time we see her as full queen, she's gonna be next level psycho. Cersei Wildfire. So I'm very excited to see Cersei do her thing this season, to see evil, and the Hound. I mean, I'm not sure what I want from the Hound's story, with him being back. I joked before, but the look in his face is why am I not dead? I wish I was dead. Give me some chickens. He's just like, all he keeps saying, the Hound just, I just see this look on his face, he just...
You're a talker. Listening to talkers makes me thirsty. If any more words come pouring out your cunt mouth, I'm gonna have to eat every fucking chicken in this room.
Yeah, I mean, he just has this look like of not giving a fuck, and I guess that's the character, and he kind of in some way does wish he was dead, and... was going through all this and what happened to him, even the brief in the episode last season and stuff, all of that's just more and more. So I hope he gets some good business to do this season, and it doesn't end up too cheesy, cliche, television-y, because I'm not sure if I think it they're on their own completely with everything to do with him. So we shall see. The Hound would be the happiest in Los Pollos Hermanos. Absolutely, Claudio. Frozen Hound. Yeah, the Hound doesn't look... The Hound's like, at least this is better than fire. And Varys... I mean, it's hard to tell what he's really thinking, but I hope we get in this last season... I hope we get a lot of him and a lot more perspective, not just him disappearing at times and then showing up in other places, like actually seeing him arrive to talk to Daenerys instead of him just showing up on a ship suddenly in magic and she's okay with him. And we don't get one of the introductions I've been looking forward to. Yes, it was great to see Tyrion with Dany and we got some good scenes with that. But I also wanted to see what is the first thing that Varys says to Daenerys. What are their interactions like? And that's one of the two character interactions I'm hoping for the most in this upcoming season, and something I really hope we get more of Varys and what his whole thing is. Are we going to get Ilario back in this season at all? Like what? I don't know. I'm very curious. Like, here he is right there on the screen, right behind her. She knows him as the spider from King's Landing. Where's the discussion? Oh, is Tyrion just like, ah, oh, he's cool. Okay, you're cool. No, she's not like that. I'm going to burn you. You almost killed me. You're the spy master that fucking sent that dude to kill me in season one. Yeah, it was season one. But whatever it was, you know what I'm talking about. Varys is too smart for Dany. If Tyrion meets with Cersei, she's going to kill him, at least try. I don't think she's going to be able to, especially if Tyrion meets her with all, you know, like, all his Dany people around him. Like, if it's in a public setting. I wonder if Cersei's just going to want to, like, reach over the table and fuck a motherfucker up. Go, you want to know how, you want to see a magic? If Cersei's like... You want to see a magic trick? And she just shoves a pencil up Tyrion's face. And I'm also curious to see the Jaime and him interaction. I don't expect Jaime to be warm with them either because of what he did to Brother Numspy. And good game ball. I don't care who dies. I just need to see if Gendry is still rowing. And that's what I'm curious too. If the next time we don't see Gendry even for a second is rowing, or they fake us out with it. I just feel bad for this girl. I hope she gets to just drop this motherfucker off. Like can they bump into Benjen again? Can you just hook this sucker up to the back of the horse? And you can just drag his ass? Come on. Poor girl. But I wonder how much Mira plays more in the storyline, if finally we will. Joe and I talked a little bit about this before. We can finally follow Mira possibly home and see what's going on with her, and then maybe they can come to the story later, or perhaps her part is done for now. I don't know. Maybe the Reeds will show up in season 8 and Mira will disappear. And Littlefinger's too. Again, I want more direct contact with Littlefinger and more development of his plot and see how he plots and plans everything that's happened in the North now. How Jon Snow is basically putting some cud in his mud. Poor Mira. Bran will accidentally raise a Rickon as a white. Cold hands, Benjen, Bran's face. She just drops Bran in the next ditch she sees right after that scene. Bran is the patriarchy. Ivar the cripple is not a bitch like Bran. How you doing, Biggie? Meters, bad luck, girls of Westeros. Will we see Storm's End? Not likely. I mean, I think we're going to see a lot of Dragonstone this year. And I think hopefully if we get some other big locations throughout the season. A couple of other big places that I want to see, like Lannisport, like fucking, I'd love to see Storm's End. I'd love to see the High Garden. I'd love to see like so many other places. The only characters in season 8 are going to be Jon, Dany, Sansa, Arya, Tyrion, Jaime, and Cersei. What's going on? Are we still doing live for 420? Actually, this is a second stream. I went off and then I came back. I just wanted to take a look at some of these images. And again, like I said, this is a short stream. I'm going to start to wrap things up now. But I'm very excited for a lot of things coming up in Game of Thrones. And I couldn't wait to just at least come out here and talk about these images and not look at them for the first time all alone. Because then, I mean, it's even more fun to touch myself inappropriately right now while you guys can't see me on the screen while these images flash than it would be to do it by myself, because ultimately that's my fetish and you guys help me live it. And thanks to Taka now with this cool image thing, you guys don't have to see me do like awkward things like when the screen comes back and stuff. And I'm suddenly like, oh, sorry, let me put my clothes back on. I think Arya is still at the Twins. Me too, Goat. It looks like she is still at the... I just want to see Ghost. I hope we at least get a scene with Ghost, let alone a possible Nymeria and Wolfpack scene, which is the long overdue Wolfpack scene. Yeah, is it too much to ask for some fucking direwolf action? No, it's not too much. I don't care. They can do it. They can afford it. 2 seasons left. 16 episodes left. Whatever it is. Don't tell me it's 15. Shut up. I don't want to hear it. 16 episodes left. And I'm holding out hope at least. They got to throw all the shit at the wall. HBO, you're making all the money here. And you're going to re-release this stuff on Blu-ray 1,000 times. You're going to release it in theaters so people can watch it. You're going to like endlessly play this shit on loop and release it to every streaming platform in existence. Like, it's going to be around forever. Throw all the money you have at these last couple of seasons, HBO. I want to see... People have said it. Ren was kind of saying this earlier, I think, in the last stream when I was being a little bitchy about the episode count again. Like, ultimately, we're going to get longer episodes. And, I mean, I'm trying to learn to like the taste of shit. You know when you really like... You really like a food that's bad for you and the doctor's like, you can't eat that shit anymore. You need to stop eating that shit. I need to stop hating on the fact that there's only going to be seven episodes and then 6 episodes. 13, not 15. Motherfucker. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Serenity now. Okay. So I need to just come to grips with that's the fact. I need to learn to eat the fucking rice cakes instead of potato chips. Excuse me. I need to not drink Coca-Cola anymore and just drink water. I need to stop hard alcohol and just drink beer. I need to stop the bitching about this because it's a fact. There's nothing I can't call them and complain. I'm not going to shame them into giving us 10 episodes in season 8. Or could we? So I'm going to try to make the best of this and hope that they're big, supercharged episodes. Big, huge, thick, face slappy. To the point where I go, fuck. Okay. That was good. I can't fucking complain. That's what I want them to do. And who gives a shit about me? But that's where I am with it. And this is the start because I'm excited about this. This is the first thing I've been excited about. I like that trailer. I like the walking trailer. I like that. But this is the first time I'm like, okay, I can feel it now. It's real. Don't fuck me over here. If you're going to pull this 7-episode shit. I know. I'm a whiny complainer. 6 and 8. Eat rice cakes. Are you from Skagosville? D. Mitchell, it's great to see you, D. Great you're able to be live with us. So I'm hoping, and Ren's mentioned this, a couple other people mentioned this, if we get 7 hour-and-a-half long episodes and they're all kick ass, I'm gonna come on here and fucking wear the shame mask. And I don't know why Batman's the shame mask. Wear the Batman mask or something. Wear my fucking furry hat on. Be like, okay, these are the best fucking 7 episodes of a television show I ever saw. I love it. I'm fine with it. I didn't need any more than that. They did exactly what they wanted to do. But if it feels like I think it might feel, where it's like feels a little rushed and bam, 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 where things could have been expanded and where this is a show, if done right, could have probably done 9 or 10 seasons if they did everything right, or not everything right, like everything they could have possibly done. But, and again, I'm being a little whiny about it, but I'm stopping that. I'm happy. 7 episodes, make these the best fucking 7 episodes we can get and make them action packed. No fucking filler, no wasting time on Masande and Grey Worm romance angles, no fucking just, no shit that we don't need. Let's just get to the fucking business and kick some ass. And that doesn't mean bang, 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 banger, 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 banger. Well, speaking of who's on screen right now, that wouldn't be a bad thing. But that just means let's, you know, no more fucking around here. Endgame shit here, okay? You want it to be endgame, then fucking wow me here. Who cares about? I mean, they don't have to wow me. What the fuck? They don't give two pisses about me. Who cares about me? My dog. D&D said they only had 15 hours worth of material at the end of the season. Yeah. Okay. Dumb shits. Don't know. A lot of people do this a lot better than I do, like the rewriting, recasting, re-putting things up. Tony has a great series. Carmine does this well, too, talking about how things could have been spread out a little bit differently to be done better. And a lot of people talk that shit better than I do, and I'm not going to sit here and pretend I can rewrite or re-space it out, but there was a way to stretch this out to a point where, and it's not stretching in a bad way, by actually using the source material and giving us enough that they would have way more than just 15 episodes. Fuck 20. They would have like 30 more episodes left of stuff that they could really do. And I know a lot of it is because they're in gray area of stuff that they don't know exactly know how it's going to pan out. So they have to write it themselves. So God forbid they use some imagination and like, and do some stuff to like really, but maybe it's a better thing. Just finish it up. But I'm really happy today. Thank you, HBO, for putting this out. And thank you for checking this live stream out. I mean, sorry that it ended with me bitching a little bit about these 7 or 8 episodes. I'm just, I don't know. I don't know. I'm more excited about Game of Thrones than I have for any television program I have been looking into after season 6, which I thought was a big step up after 5. Looking to season 7 and 8, I was excited. Oh, 2 more full seasons of action. And now we're going to get 2 lesser, not quite as full seasons. We've got 15 episodes. And I hope these are the greatest 150 minutes of my, you know, 150 minutes. Like it's a minute. 15 hours of television ever. They might not even end up being an hour long. They could all be 50 minutes. And that's the thing, Ren. These could be 7 50-minute episodes or 46 minutes. And Carmine talked a lot about this really well on his reviews last season about timing out the episodes and seeing with like all the HBO shit that they put in the front end now and all the previews for the previews and the back end with the directors talking and all that sort of shit. Episodes proper were getting shorter and shorter. And They're getting the season shorter, and if they don't give us supercharged episodes and they give us just normal 45-minute episodes, 50-minute episodes, and only 7 of them, 15 just doesn't feel like enough. But I might just being a spoiled asshole, which I am prone to be. Just ask anyone that knows me. But I can't say how excited I am for season 7 or 8. I think it's great television, aside from everything to do with book universe versus show universe and all of that whole thing, which is sort of underlining in what I'm saying, that they don't have the material. But just as television writers in like a fun television romp, I just would have wanted full seasons at the end. I hated when shows do this. I hated when The Sopranos did this at the end, split the seasons in half and you get 2 half of seasons and half of it's a Kevin Finnery bullshit. I don't like, why do they have to change stuff for the last season sometimes and things like that? You only have people screaming at the screen. Asshole. They only have 15 hours worth of shit to tell. I just hear that Billy Crystal's wife and Princess Bride, Laka's wife too. Liars! Liar! 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 But we shall see. Duncan Egg signs a nude scene. I'm just reading in the live chat. I'm feeling very hopeful there won't be any filler on March anyways. This is Endgame, Phil. Phil just said it. It's got to be consistent epicness. I agree. And it doesn't mean we can't have an arc. Right? We know the first episode's going to be a lot of building, but I want to feel like the stakes are set. Like the race has begun. The gun has been fired, and this is the race to the end, essentially. And I want to feel that right from the beginning of the season. Make it a ride for us. And that doesn't mean it has to go bang, 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 bang. Like I said, you don't have to constantly bang it. Some rhythm helps. I just want to see not much wasting time, just getting right to it. Hey, what's up? Even Breaking Bad didn't master that final season. KLC, I was just going to say that too. And Joe talks a lot about this. He really hated season 5, part 1, which was an added season because AMC demanded extra episodes from Vince Gilligan and crew. Or not demand, we're like, well, people really love it. You got to put out more. So they kind of concocted the whole... section, or they decide to go in the direction of them forming a crew, having to steal the computer and all the drug stuff when they kind of got all schemey for that part of season 5. So a lot of shows fail at that. And I mean, I'm hoping Game of Thrones succeeds in it and really kicks ass here in these episodes. And I don't see why not. I just think there's a lot of buildup for this, considering the put off till July. And then how long are we going to have to wait for July until season 8? Are we going to have to wait till the next July, or are we going to have to wait till April? Like from July, or is it going to be a shortened wait? I've heard people rumor that it might be a shortened wait in between the end of 7 and beginning of 8. Like we might not have to wait a full year. I've heard a couple people mention that. People maybe attached to working on set. And a couple things that there's talks about it being a shorter gap between 7 and 8. So maybe we could theoretically see July be Game of Thrones season 7 and January, February, March, like still in winter, have the final season of Game of Thrones come, or maybe in April when the seasons usually air. I hope we don't have to wait July to July, or, you know, August to July. You know what I mean? I hope they don't make us wait a whole full calendar year for 6 episodes of Game of Thrones. I said this a lot towards the end of the season, and someone might say this in the live chat. I think that they're going to maybe film a lot of these season 7 and 8 together. Then wait till September and give me 15 episodes. Give us 15 episodes of Game of Thrones to end the entire series. All in a row. 15 weeks. Fuck all. Time it out where so it doesn't bump into the holidays or whatever. I'm not doing the math right, but if it's really just going to be 15 episodes and they're going to make us wait a year or maybe even then some part of me would have hoped that if they were just going to do it this way, then fuck it. Have season 7 be the last season and have it be 15 episodes. That would probably July 2018 for series 8. It will still be in the winter, says the goat. Bullshit, Phil. They hate us. It won't happen in September 2019. Sweet summer child. We'll be happy if the wait is 12 months. Phil, oh, sweet summer child. I am born in May. I'm a summer child. All visual and weak content like season 6. 2020 for 2-hour finale. So lucky. The season doesn't know when how many episodes we'll have. Probably will die, says Martin. But Phil, they'll have to beat the horse until it's dead, then beat it some more. That's what they did with The Sopranos. And that was one of the things I really hated about what they did with The Sopranos. The Sopranos, they did the season 6 first half, and then there was all this talk whether season 6B would even happen. And then you had to wait like so long between B and A. And I think if you're giving us 7 episodes and then it's only 6 left, and I know I'm going to wait. The hype is going to build and everything like that, but wouldn't you just rather them give it to us just a couple months later? Like, just do a little break in between 7 and 8 and then give it to us right the next year, like bang in April or bang in January or something like that. But you're right. They're probably not going to do it. They're going to have to wait till 2018. They're going to milk the cow for as long as they can milk it. Build all this hype, build all this build up to season 8 of Game of Thrones, all this pre-season press, this whole cottage industry that exists with building the trailers and the teasers and hyping up Game of Thrones at the Comic-Cons and the yearly events that they show the trailers and release the casting videos for the next year and all that shit. The whole process would be interrupted and already was a little bit with the year. So why wouldn't they? I just really... Again, there's a lot of hope at the end of this stream. There's a lot of wishes. There's a lot of me sitting and praying to Miss Cleo in this stream. Oh, everybody, will you... Oh, wrong button again. Oh, everybody, please, I beg of you. If wishes were horse and nuts and butts, whatever that expression is. I think that's the correct expression. But that's what I hope. I'm hoping that they don't make us wait that full year. At least. You could at least do that. Least if you're gonna fuck us, give us the reach around a little bit. Come on, be nice about it. Let's go in the live chat. Saw the Mel actress in the hag makeup claims to be a leaked photo. Who cares when we waited this long? HBO is desperate. They don't have another big show. Westworld is taking forever between seasons, which might even get pushed off again and just doesn't have the same... Even though Westworld hit critically, it didn't hit as... Maybe it would down the road, but it's still not a hit like Game of Thrones is a hit and like The Sopranos were. And I think those are the... Game of Thrones is real. HBO's had a lot of other really great successes since then. But I think for big turning articles, at the lead articles, like turning heads, that people that aren't just into shows and stuff, The Sopranos and Game of Thrones crossed into mainstream. Like a great band whose song crossed into the mainstream. Those two series are a little bit above the pack of popularity. Some could argue Sex and the City could be in there too, but I think it's a different kind of series. Between us motherfucking chatters, I'm kind of tired of seeing Game of Thrones and Walking Dead actors in every other show and movie. Just me, I'm sure. I don't know, it takes me out of character sometimes with certain parts I mind and certain parts I don't, and certain actors I mind. It's very personal with that. I don't think you're far off in that. I think there is an issue there, but I think it's our problem, not theirs. Like, we can't discredit the actors for wanting to work, but I agree that sometimes when you see certain actors in other parts, it takes you out of the moment because you only see that character, especially if you see them before you see them in another part, so it's hard to take them seriously. And milk it with some box sets. You're right, Ian. Game of Thrones movie with Kevin fucking Costner's old chunks. No. Rest in peace, Miss Cleo. I have a ticket with the number 10 for the line to fuck the red woman. Anyone want to trade for a Danny ticket or a 10 or higher? Tim Gersh is back in the live motherfucking chat. So I just want to thank you guys for allowing me to come out here for 5 minutes. I mean, I really wanted this stream to just be like a 5-10 minute thing that I came out here and talked. One of my most fun things to do is talk about Game of Thrones. So I was scared that maybe this might turn into like an hour stream or something like that. And I'm glad that that didn't happen with my bitching and moaning about some stuff that no one really wants to hear, you know? No, but on the serious, thank you to everyone that going to start to sort of wrap things up in a minute. Take a little bit more questions from the live motherfucking chat before we go. But I want to thank everyone that checked out this stream or checked out the 420 stream that I did before this. If anyone didn't check out that, you can see earlier today I did another quick stream basically about 420 stuff. And happy 420 to anyone who celebrates the hippie holiday. Everyone's got a day now. Hey, Al Red Sox fan. Great to see you, buddy. Ren Renwood. Great to see everybody. I love Westworld, but honestly, I haven't thought about it much since season one finished, which says a lot for me personally. Doesn't say a lot for you personally. I think I've thought about it a little bit, but more thinking about season two. My brain has been in other television shows. Until Game of Thrones finishes, that my prime television focus is kind of laser-eyed on it. It doesn't mean I can't enjoy other series. Better Call Saul, Vikings, Westworld are like on the tops of my next tier of my favorite TV shows that are on right now. But I'm all encompassed by Game of Thrones. Even when I'm talking about another series, I'm sitting there wishing or like talking about that other series, if you know what I'm talking about. Don't want to badmouth it. When I'm talking about that other series that I talk about in October's, I'm wishing I was talking about Game of Thrones. I feel like I'm cheating on Game of Thrones with some other subpar series. Not making any friends in that community. So anyways, we're definitely not making any Walking Dead friends this season, Joe and I. That's Joe and I being bitter that Game of Thrones isn't coming sooner all season and taking it out of The Walking Dead. Let's get to the truth of it now. Anyways, so you're right. Wind Tower is no longer my screen focus. It's my second wife, Cersei. Big fun, Phil. Looks like you're having fun with OBS stream. Thank you, Uncle. Taka and I figured out the sync issue with the audio, and I think we're pretty much lined up. And it's I think we're pretty good. Any alone stream I'll be doing on OBS just because I can do more things on the screen. I got to experiment with getting Joe on Skype and putting him up in the corner and stuff so I can do other broadcasts from this way as well. And I think there might be another way, too, with adding a camera to the stream. But I got to look into that and talk to do a little bit of research on that. But anyways. Into the Badlands, we will be doing a single podcast at the end of the Into the Badlands season with myself, Taka, and Joe. Reviewing the whole season of Into the Badlands. If you want to listen to some weekly episode content for that, check out Dirty Issues Gaming to check out Taka's live streams of, he does live reaction videos of each episode of that, which is really awesome. But the end of the season of Into the Badlands, because I have to catch up. I haven't watched any episodes of it this season. Joe's been watching it though. And I just want to binge watch the whole season at the end and then do the podcast with Joe and Taka. So expect that at the end of the Into the Badlands season. There'll definitely be some coverage of that. So here we motherfucking go. Yeah, the instead of broadcasting live through the Hangouts Iron for this stream and a couple of other streams we've done, I'm broadcasting with the OBS program. It's just a streaming program that instead of streaming through YouTube, I'm streaming to YouTube from my computer. And I can do a few more things on it, like have the live chat on the screen, have my overlay thing back again and put pictures on and videos and stuff. But I'm still kind of working out some of the technical kinks of it and a little awkward in some of the transitions because I don't know where the buttons are yet. So if I'm like, oh, where the fuck am I? Ah. But it's allowing me to do a couple more fun things in these live streams. So hopefully we'll be able to experiment with this stuff more. Definitely still going to be using the Hangouts too because it doesn't affect the live chat still there. And it's the easiest way to do a call with other people doing a podcast unless I connect with them on Skype. So I'll be experimenting with that sort of shit and Yeah, I appreciate you guys checking it out as my Santa Claus the Santa Claus streams continues. Sons of Anarchy is a very, very fun show. I think you need to get past, for some people that have had trouble with Sons of Anarchy, have trouble with Charlie Hunnam's acting in the first season, and I think he sucks in the first season. I think he progressively gets better throughout the series when he starts to feel more comfortable about himself. So I would definitely check that out. But here we go. Oh, very cool stuff. Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. And thank you so much for everyone checking it out. Yeah, lots of love to OBS Project. You know, freeware. Everyone can use it. It's a very awesome program, similar to XSplit and Live and Wirecast and stuff like that, but free sourced. So free sourced. Thank you. Thank you for the funding of that and the computer from Papa Tucka. Yeah, and I think it was the type of show, Av, that it could do that. You know, it excelled at going over the top. But let me just wrap up the Game of Thrones stuff here. So these are the pictures of Game of Thrones. The first images released. Again, I'll continue because this is really, really easy to do stuff like this. As more Game of Thrones stuff is released, I'll come on and talk more and more about it as the trailers come on. Probably do my live trailer reactions this way now, too. This is working really well as a good way to stream and get the live motherfucking chat and stream more. It's a lot easier than having to do the screen capture stuff as Tim can attest to when I used to try to play trailers like that. He's like, don't even try to fucking play the trailer. It's going to run too choppy and shit. But yeah, thank you so much, everybody. And I'm not quite going, but anyone that's just here for Game of Thrones, we've kind of already gone off Game of Thrones, but I might babble for a few more minutes before I wrap things up and go to the live motherfucking chat for some questions and keep the photos rolling for anyone who hasn't seen them down in the corner. So let's get hyped. Let's get excited. 3 months away, less than fucking 3 months away. Game of Thrones is coming all over our face, whether we like it or not. 7 episodes, 15 episodes, whether we like it or not. Let's just be happy. Let's be like little children in kindergarten where we get what we get and we don't get upset. No fucking way, but I'm still gonna love it, and I'm still excited for it, and I'm still squeezing these nipples. So, thank you, everybody, and yes. Phil, check out Order of the Green Hand YouTube channel. They go into some great theories, but they don't buy the R plus L equals J. I will definitely try to check them out. Pasta, ice cream, and pancakes with smiley face. Peace out, everybody. So I'm just going to start to say my goodbyes here. So everyone, thank you so much for joining me for this live stream. You guys have all been awesome, and thank you for joining me for the last live stream. Motherfucking hype, Game of Thrones is coming. I cannot fucking believe it. These photos are really great. Let's go one more time through the whole slideshow, and then I will call it a stream. One more big, big slideshow. Let's push this up. We got Jaime and Cersei. Cersei thinking, unlimited power! And Jaime being like, I gotta stab this bitch to save my face. I gotta kill her. I gotta kill her soon. I hope Tyrion gets in his ear and convinces him to kill the crazy, amazing Cersei. I love Cersei. She's amazing, but she's crazy. And she's thinking, I'm so cool and so fucking, I'm awesome, I'm awesome, I'm awesome. People love me. Why do people love me so much? Because I'm awesome, because I'm a badass. I hope she gets the sword back. I hope Jon offers her the sword back. Am I missing a scene where she does offer her the sword back? But I hope he does, and I hope Jorah gets to meet her somehow. And here is Phil the Issues Guy. Hi, everybody. This is Phil the Issues Guy. A year from now doing the podcast. Seriously, no bullshit. That's me in a year doing this podcast. Game of Thrones Season 8, that's what I'm going to look like. Okay, here we go. Reading about some theories. We've got people on Reddit right now zooming in on these words and analyzing it. You know it's happening. Please check out Beyond the Wall, where the free folk lie on Reddit. You know someone has already analyzed all of this there. Lady Mormont should be queen. Done. And here comes, what were you doing all day? I'm just pulling. Poor Mira just can't wait to get home. And Bran, as people said, just not giving any fucks, just sitting up being like, fuck. Fuck, dude. I do wish. Hey, how you doing? How you doing? How you doing? Seriously, where's the caption? How you doing? Tim wants to have sex with Cersei, but 70% of the time it will end with him on fire. Oh, gosh. Okay, Littlefinger. What are the odds Littlefinger saying something promoting and really right on the level, and there he has no agenda to this conversation that he's having? I think probably whatever he's saying is helpful to Sansa and in no way helpful and beneficial to himself in the future. And in no way going to, speaking of people, the shiny, happy people holding hands. The happiest man in all of Westeros. Literally, there's no one happier than him. Here he is, the best.
You're a talker. Listening to talkers makes me thirsty.
Yeah, okay, I'll shut up, dude, okay?
If any more words...
Okay, and then, of course, we have the one and only Jon Snow looking as sexy as ever. Hey, buddy, what's going on?
Hi, Phil. I know I don't do you as well.
Wait, hey, no, I was going to say, I know you don't do me as well as David.
Hey, David does me great.
Yes, he does you great. I'm not trying to do you, I'm just... And then Arya, thank you, Arya, for saving me there. Thinking, I'm so happy. Probably maybe a quick flashback to right before she kills Walder Frey or something like that. Or maybe just right after she killed Walder Frey, glowing, hanging out the twins. I do think this is the twins' color. love our friend Arya. And then we have Daenerys, as I mentioned before, probably thinking about burning somebody or talking about breaking some wheel or doing something or some other thing, being hypocritical and mad kingish and queenish and being very nice and to people because she's a people person. And yep. And this is Varys plotting, like not even hiding his plotting. Or showing her reverence or looking at something horrible. Like Tyrion waking up from a drunken stupor. I'm hoping. At this point, I want to see... Hey, Missandei, I know you're Brokes girl, but do you want to go to a movie? Come on, Missandei. Missandei, will you be my best friend, Missandei? Hi, Masande. Hey, you know what I have that Grey Worm doesn't have, Masande? Tyrion looking cool as fuck. As I mentioned, I hope Tyrion gets a lot of good stuff to do. Yes, I think Dany is going on the throne to Dragonstone. Absolutely have. The motherfucking hound. Dany uses her hand for a bong. And here's our whole team. And I think that's it. Are we swinging around again? Do we get to unlimited power one more time? Yeah, and unlimited power. So those are the Game of Thrones season 7 set photos. A bunch of times, a bunch of really awkward goofiness. But I do appreciate everyone checking out this stream. And if you haven't already and you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button. Thank you to the live motherfucking chat. The best live motherfucking chat in the fucking world. Love you guys. The one and the only motherfucking chat. Tyrion does look does look badass. Looks like they're playing zone defense. Tyrion looks badass. Did Grey Worm get everything cut off or just his balls? I believe we've talked about this before. I think it's just the balls. Is it? Or is it balls and stem? I think Varys was balls and stem. It depends. Like, he probably was balls and stem. I'm just thinking some eunuchs in cases just had balls chopped off, but It's an interesting thought. I'm very curious. Both the pillar and the stones were removed, says John. Thank you, John. Phil, what was the point of Dorne again? To completely fuck over my buddy, Dr. Julian Bashir? That was the point of Dorne. Because just to fuck over Julian Bashir? And make it so no other Deep Space Nine actors show up on fucking Game of Thrones? Tyrion should bring the space plants too. I think so. I think he has to. And on that note, everybody, you guys are amazing. Thank you so much. Where the fuck is it? Where is it? Where do I want to play here? Wrong. Oh, shit. Wrong one.
Now, this is a story all about how Westeros got flipped, turned upside down. If you want to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you all about the quest to take the Iron Chair.
Whoops, wrong song. I pushed the wrong song, but it was hard to turn it off. This one I meant to push.
So let's play a game. Which body part do you need the least? You've been wondering.
This is Ramsay Snow, my bastard.
Who I am.
You're just
wonderful.
Meat. Stinking meat.
You're just
wonderful.
Pork sausage.
That's a good name for you.
You freak.
Pork sausage.
For the watch.
Pork sausage.
Watch.
Pork sausage.
For the watch.
Pork sausage.
For the watch. For the watch.
Kill Jon Snow.
Boy.
Reek.
Boy.
Reek. For the watch.
My watch is ended. Boy. Boy.
Pour me some wine.
I am Lord Bob. I prefer being an only child. My mother taught me not to throw stones at cripples.
Pete's live music. Thank you so much for this, Pete.
Aim for their head.
From this day until your last day, you are Ramsay Bolton, son of Roose Bolton, Warden of the North.
Pork sausage.
You smell particularly right this evening.
Surrender. A surrender.
And I accept your surrender.
No, it's me vocalizing, not guitar. That dude that just went, yeah! That's my
wife.
And this song is called Analysis Paralysis. It was a remix done by Pete's Live Music, who added this Bastard Bull one. There's this Bastard Bull one, a Tyrion one, and a Bronn one he did for us on a song of ours called Analysis Paralysis of a band called Mosquito Gonzalez.
I win.
He wins. Good night, everybody. Thank you so much. You can find the link to that song and songs used on the show. It will send you to a SoundCloud page that has some of my old band songs. And if not, message me privately if you guys maybe want some of those links, or maybe I can make them available somewhere at some point. Some of those remixes that Pete did, because they're a lot of fun. And again, thank you, everybody. I'll talk to you guys next time. Good night. Good night, I said.